Starfield Grav Jump mechanics are based on four interconnected parameters: jump thrust, jump range, fuel tank's capacity, and the mass of your ship. In this video, we'll look at how these stats related to each other and how the Grav Jumps mechanic works, how to choose the right Grav Drive and Tank for your ship, and what warnings you can get when plotting a route. Any route on the star map is a chain of Grav Jumps from one star system to another. You can't make any trip that jumps through a star system you haven't visited before, and if you try, you'll see an unexplored route warning. Grav Jump Thrust determines the maximum jump range of your ship. Jump range is the maximum distance between two stars your ship can handle. If you try to make a jump that exceeds your jump range, you will get a out-of-range warning on the star map. Grav Drive consumes heliometry fuel, which is in your ship's tanks. The total capacity of all your ship's tanks only determines how long you can go without refueling. You don't have to worry about refueling, as the game automatically performs refueling when your ship enters a star system. If you try to plot a route that uses more fuel than your ship can carry, you will get an out-of-fuel-range warning. Jump range of your ship depends on only two parameters, the Grav Drive thrust and the mass of your ship. Here is a formula that defines this dependence. Let's see how this formula works. Points obtained for a ship with NG150 Grav Drive for different values of the ship's mass. As we can see, all these points fit perfectly on the formula curve. The same for Apollo GV300 Grav Drive with thrust 50. You can increase your ship jump range by upgrading your astrodynamics skill. Rank 1 gives you 15% and rank 3 30% for jump range. In theory, your ship's crew member who have the astrodynamic skill should increase the jump range of your ship. Sarah Morgan is the best choice for it. She has rank 4. But the astrodynamic skill works differently for crew member than for you, and as it's written in the description for this skill. This skill for a crew member does not affect the jump range in any way, but it only reduces the fuel consumption of your Grav Drive, moreover approximately 7.5% for each rank. That is, Sarah, who has rank 4, will reduce fuel consumption by 30% and not by 50%. So, as we can see, there are three options to increase jump range. First, install a Grav Drive with more thrust. Second, reduce the mass of your ship. And third, pump up your astrodynamics skill. It's not the best option to immediately install the most expensive and most powerful Grav Drive on your ship. The higher the thrust of the Grav Drive, the greater its mass, as a rule. Which means the greater the mass of your ship will be. The mass of Grav Drive grows almost linearly with its thrust. More powerful Grav Drives will significantly increase the mass of your ship. And as the mass of your ship increases, its mobility will decrease, which will lead to a serious deterioration in its combat characteristics and higher vulnerability on the battlefield. Does it exist at all an optimal Grav Drive, so as not to significantly degrade the combat characteristics of the ship, and at the same time so that we have enough Grav Jump Thrust and can travel without limitations through the galaxy? To travel through almost entire galaxy, a Grav Drive will be enough, which will allow your ship to jump at 23 light years. Except the three farthest areas. Three-star system near Archimedes. To reach this area, your ship must have a jump range of 24 light years. Vena system. Here you need a ship with a jump range of 25 light years. And the third area is around Zhelazny. Here you need 28 light years. In Starfield, the maximum jump range, regardless of the thrust of your Grav Drive and the mass of your ship, is limited to 30 light years. As we can see, it's redundant to design your ship to jump 30 light years. To travel through the galaxy, 28 is absolutely enough. If you aren't yet interested in these three areas, you can design your ship for 23 light years. The fuel consumption of a ship is determined by two parameters: the length of the road and the jump thrust of your ship. Here is the formula that defines this dependence. Let's see how this formula works. The points obtained for grav jumps over a fixed distance. As we can see, all these points fit perfectly on a straight line. To reduce fuel consumption, there are three options. The first, upgrade your astrodynamic skill. The second, 10 magazines, Nova Galactic Manuals. Everyone give you a reduction on grav jump fuel by 1%. So the total effect will be 10%. And the third, add crew member with astronomic skill to your ship. It could be Sarah Morgan. We already discussed it in part 2 of this video. Sarah will give you an additional 30 reduction in fuel consumption. This 30% stacks multiplicatively with your astrodynamic skill rank. That is, if you have rank 4 astrodynamic skill, you will end up getting a 65% reduction in fuel consumption. Everything is simple here. The minimum tank capacity should be such that you can perform your longest grav jump. For example, for my main combat fighter, here are its stats. The minimum tank capacity should be like this. 28 light years is enough to travel around the galaxy without limitations. So, in my case, we get. That is, any tank with a capacity greater than 154 will suit me. As a result, on this ship I use this tank. If you have chosen a tank for yourself in this way, but it's not enough to travel along some routes, then such a route can always be divided into parts, and you can go through this chain of jumps in separate parts. At the end of this video, a short summary of warnings that may appear when plotting a route through the galaxy. Out of range. It means that your ship's grav jump range is not enough to jump to another star system. In this case, you need. Out of fuel range. It means that it's not enough fuel in your fuel tanks to complete the road. In this case, you need. Unexplored route. It means that you try to make a trip that jumps through a star system you have not visited before. In this case, you just need to visit these star systems. For example, here, instead of one jump, you will have to do three. Once you have visited all the systems, you will be able to make this jump in one go. That's it. Thank you for watching the video. Like the video if you enjoy and subscribe if you are new, and thank you to my returning viewers. I'll see you next time.